Listening to music, is it okay or not okay? We spoke about it repeatedly, and Arij already says that she knew that it is prohibited. The Prophet ﷺ did not allow it. And Mufassirin said, pertaining the ayah of Surah Luqman 2, that is approved that listening to music is not permissible. And only musical instrument which may be used during certain occasions, such as wedding and Eids, is the daf or the duf. The Prophet ﷺ said in the sound hadith, which is collected by Imam al-Bukhari, that there will be time. سَيَأْتِ زَمَانٌ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى وَالْحَرِيرِ وَالْخَمْرَ وَالْمَعَازِفِ. The time will come when some of my followers will treat as lawful and will be indulged in the following illegal activities and consider it okay: adultery, wearing silk for men, drinking, and listening to musical instruments. It is shocking that you see how many Muslims drink. It says, you know, spiritual drinks. It's just a little sip. It's a beer, it's not wine. Some people differentiate between the beer and the wine. It's all alcohol. وَمَا أَسْكَرَ كَثِيرُهُ فَقَلِيلُهُ حَرَامٌ. Anything that if you drink a bottle of it, a barrel of it, will make you intoxicated or drunk, then even a little sip of it is prohibited, will be treated as alcohol. But it is happening. It is happening that men do not, many men do not really care whether this is silk or gold. They don't mind. They say we are in the 21st century. It's also happening that boys and girls who bear Muslim names do have boyfriends and girlfriends, right? The prophecy of the Prophet ﷺ has come true. والمعازف, musical instruments. So when the Prophet ﷺ combined the four things in the warning that the time will come where people will treat them as legal, what does it mean? These four items are not permissible, and indulging in any of these sins is a major sin, is a kabira. There are many other hadith. It may not be highly sound, but this hadith is more than sufficient. So you've been trying, because you've been listening to it. Music is the instrument of the shaitan, of Satan. He possesses people through it. He makes them think that they cannot live without it. It is the tongue and a tool of Satan to reach to your heart. And the person who listens to music finds it extremely hard to read the Quran. And when they occasionally read it, they don't understand it, or it does not leave that impact on their hearts, on their behavior, because they're disconnected. You either connect yourself to this or to that. Listen to the Quran, stop listening to music. This is the best alternative. And you earn reward here for each letter you listen to or recite, while you acquire a lot of punishment and anger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while you're listening to music. And normally it doesn't come alone, music and songs. And some people say, yeah, listening to good songs is okay. Fine. Name a good song. All the songs along with music, love and love affairs, boyfriend and girlfriend, yani inviting people to commit the haram and get sucked in whatever is prohibited. As far as the nasheed, it is okay, as long as the nasheed does not contain words that invite to what's prohibited. And meanwhile, it's not sang by a woman, if men would listen to it, and it's not with musical instruments. So those nasheeds with percussion or just the sound and humming, that is permissible, inshaAllah Azza wa Jal. And guess what? We live without it. I mean, I can survive without listening to music. As a matter of fact, I enjoy my life without listening to music. It's as simple as that. And if you want something to help you to quit right now, and not to keep coming back and forth, going back and forth, we're listening and not listening, take this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حفت الجنة بالمكاره وحفت النار بالشهوات. الجنة is surrounded and camouflaged with things which a person and his self dislike, such as getting up to pray at Fajr or at night, fasting, giving from my own money, restraining my tongue and mouth from uttering what is prohibited, or backbiting or mocking others. People like to do things of this nature. But guess what? In order to go to Al-Jannah, to enter paradise, you have to distance yourself from these makarih, from what's prohibited. And you have to be patient with the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, حُفَّتِ النَّارُ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. And the farafil is surrounded with the things which the self desires. Women, have fun, drink, dance, go out with boys and girls, steal, lottery, whatever is prohibited, is right at the edge and the door of the far of hell. So you get into that, you get in close to the far of hell. Repent unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every time you fall into the sin of listening to the music. Repent frequently and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And nothing is impossible. If you keep invoking Allah, oh Allah, make it easy for me to distance myself from that and to hate listening to that, Allah definitely will help you. And I pray for you and for myself and all the Muslim brothers and sisters, the Muslim Ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to fulfill what He ordained upon us and distance us from whatever He prohibited. Amen.